Thing. It's like a normal quiz that's been bitten by a radioactive spider. This is a quiz about everything, and by everything we mean anything, so just go with it. Feel free to play along at home, or be a dick about us on Twitter, whatever you feel is the best use of your time. Let's meet the teams. One cut his teeth as a teacher, the other cut his teeth to deter ivory poachers. It's Romesh, Ranganathan and Alan Carr. She stars in the award-winning comedy Brooklyn Nine-Nine, and he, I assume, has won some sort of competition to be here tonight. It's Chelsea Peretti and Dara Briain. And lock up your daughters, because these two might try to steal their clothes. It's Noel Fielding and it is ours. Alan, you've got a degree in, it says, drama and theatre studies. Is that going to be of any use this evening?
No, yeah, because I ain't got no range as an actor. I couldn't get on that course, so I had to just be, like, theatre studies, which we mainly wear, like, a black all-in-one and move the furniture around when the lights go down. And then wonder why you couldn't get an agent, yeah.
Well, you're saying you don't have range as an actor. Surely you could play a hard man, couldn't you?
you could play a hard man.
Romesh, you used to be a teacher.
Yes.
So, I mean, you should be good at this, right?
Well, I mean, I taught in Crawley, so it didn't really test any levels of sort of... You just have to say, you know, don't burn that, please don't... please don't stab him. You know, those are sort of...
What did you actually teach?
Maths.
What's a maths fan's end? We got the trigonometry crew, what? Yeah. do you have a team name?
We look quite alike, don't we? You're lucky like that.
Yeah. The twins.
You're saying you look alike. How bad is your eyesight?
I like it. The twins. Let's go for it. Let's go
the twins.
It.
You're going to call yourself the twins. Sure. Now, Chelsea, you did the Big Fat Quiz before. What did you learn last time you were on the show?
Just to be patient.
Okay. Now, Dara, you studied mathematics and theoretical physics.
Yeah, I did. Yeah, I did all that stuff.
Is that going to come in handy this evening?
I don't know. You have the questions. How would I know? This is like the fundamental thing of a quiz. Like, you don't ask the people attending the quiz, what would you like to come up? Well, members of my family. Can you ask questions about them? That'd be great.
Question number one, Dara's mum's name.
I know this one.
Oh, a lovely lady. You take that back, Ranganathan.
Sorry, I take it back. Took it back again and again.
That's not even a thing. Watch me take it back.
That's not even a thing.
Have you guys got a team name?
The Two Crazy Foreigners.
No, you guys don't like foreigners. Sorry, we'll go with... We'll play it safe.
We decided to have like our cute showbiz couple name. So we are actually from here on in officially known as Darsea O'Perettiain.
Darsea O'Perettiain. Okay, I'm going to talk to these two fabulous guys. Eddie, you ran 27 marathons earlier this year. Phenomenal. It was through South Africa, right? One for every year Nelson Mandela was in prison, right?
Indeed it was.
Unbelievable.
And my kidneys were going, whoa, what's going on, Mike? And I don't know who Mike was, but...
What happened with your kidneys? Because you had a, you were quite ill, weren't you, after the first one?
I've got them here.
Yeah. But no, I had to go to hospital on day five, and it looked like my kidneys were going south. Right. So I needed a nephrologist, which you guys will know about.
Yes.
And
yes.
He came and said, I know Neph.
Why is no one looking at me? Just because I spent half my life in a leotard does not mean I'm a moron.
Alan, I'm very sorry. I'm very sorry. Tell me what a nephrologist is.
Oh,
I'm pretty sure
I can mime it. I can mime it.
That's exactly right.
So, Noel and Eddie, team name. What are you going to go with?
We could be good and bad kidneys, like good and bad cop.
The nephrologists.
No. What about just the phrologists?
Phrologists, I like
that. Phrologists.
Yeah, that's fine with me.
The phrologists it is. Right, the first round is all about history. The gunpowder plot of 1605 is still commemorated every year. After he was caught, Guy Fawkes was hung, drawn and quartered, which would have hurt a lot more if he wasn't made from scrunched-up newspaper and mum's old tights. After the Wall Street crash of 1929, many Americans had to tighten their belts, which, as you know, is not easy for most Americans. Of course, it wouldn't be a quiz without questions, so eyes down, everyone. OK, first question, you ready? What's Dara's mum doing?
I told you, she's sleeping soundly. That's what she's doing, happily, not knowing about any of this conversation, all right? That's she is. Untroubled by your filth.
That's because Romesh went by earlier.
Dropped off some hot chocolate, if you know what I mean.
First question. For our first question, it's over to chart sensation and part-time historian Jess Glynn.
Hello, Jimmy. Now, like me, the Roman Emperor Nero loved to perform in front of a crowd, except that he was terrible at it. He couldn't sing. His concerts went on for hours and hours, and the audience were forbidden to leave. What extreme measures did people have to take to escape from his lengthy recitals?
So, what do people have to do to get out of the concert? That's what she wants to know.
What can they possibly be talking about?
What's that got to do with you?
What's it to do with the quiz?
Yes.
We're talking about what they would do when Nero sang.
Yeah. To get away from his concerts, actually, no?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
You look like you're just mucking about and enjoying yourselves. And having a little catch-up.
Which is not what this show's about.
No.
OK, next question. Once again, the children of Mitchellbrook Primary School have put on one of their special school plays. What historical event are they acting out here?
My hat's made out of gold.
Look at my golden shoes.
We got so much money.
I want to go to France. But we don't have enough money. And I don't like her anymore.
Tough.
You're fired.
That's not fair.
I'm in charge now. Now you have to give us all your money.
Oh, no!
God, put it down.
Get married again.
I don't know if you saw Wolf Hall, but that was so much better. So what are they acting out there? Which historical event?
No, not me. I directed that. Never read the script.
All right, question number three. The mystical Stonehenge was built 5,000 years ago. In the 19th century, visitors to the site were given something to enhance their experience. What were they given? So visitors were sort of given something on the way in to sort of, you know, make it more of a fun day out.
Oh, sorry, it's the fun police.
Alan, ultimately it's your own time you're wasting.
How is Noel the serious one?
I was just trying it out. It's a new character for me. I have written mushrooms.
Yeah. All right, Next question. Take a look at this footage of American preacher Billy Sunday. What's got his knickers in a twist?
I'll fight the saloon from Hawaii to Hoboken. I'll kick it as long as I have a foot. I'll punch it as long as I have a fist. I'll butt it as long as I have a head. I'll bite it as long as I have a tooth. And when I'm old and fistless and footless and toothless, I'll gob it till I go home to heaven and it goes home, my friend, to hell.
I saw something very similar outside Crawley Weatherspoons the other night.
So I want to know what's got his knickers in a twist. What is he upset about?
Wow. No, you do it. Your handwriting.
This is phenomenal.
Is everyone finished? Have we all got something down? Oh, Eddie's just writing.
We've been done for some time now.
We've been resting.
Right, ready for some answers. Okay, first answer. Jess Glynn asked you what excuse people had to use to get out of one of Emperor Nero's concerts. What did you think?
We write, like, commit a crime and then you go to jail so you don't have to listen to it anymore. sitting there and you're going, this is shit, so you stab someone in the neck. And then you get carted off or whatever.
You're kind of close with that in a weird way.
Oh, yes.
Really?
What have you got? Dara, Chelsea?
We wrote fake leg.
Because, you know, you'd say, oh, I'm sorry, I can't go, I got a fake leg.
I thought you were already there at the concert.
You were already there in the question, yes.
It's not a case of going, you're already in there.
Yeah, that's true.
I've got to go, I've got a fake leg.
I only borrowed it.
It's got to be back at the prosthetic limb library by 12 or I get a fine.
I feel like Noel and Eddie, you could tell me you said anything and I wouldn't be any the wiser.
Eddie's got doctor's handwriting. I have no idea what he said either.
I can't even read my handwriting.
What they did to get out of having to listen to a concert is they set fire to Rome.
Well, the actual answer is the only way they could leave the concerts by Emperor Nero is if they pretended they were dead. They had to fake their death.
What, and then get up and walk out? I'm dead, I'm just ordering an Uber. I am dead, though. Definitely dead.
Okay, so no points for anyone on that. Answer number two. I asked you what the children of Mitchellbrook Primary School were acting out. What event from history was it? Chelsea, what did you put?
Louis C.K.'s dissolution of the monasteries. The little guy with the red beard we assumed was Louis C.K.
So Louis C.K. wanted to get divorced. And so Louis C.K. broke up the monasteries and stole all their gold.
Okay. But what have you got?
The dissolution of the monasteries.
But shouldn't they have to specify that it was Louis C.K.?
Yeah. Like a central historical detail in this.
Shouldn't you have to specify what I specify?
What did you specify, Eddie?
No one knows. Look at that. That is not calligraphy.
No, first and second act of suppression by Henry VIII in 1536 and 1539.
Well, I'm afraid we need a slightly more complete answer. Well, you're absolutely right. Points all round.
Well done, guys. Feels good when you take it seriously, doesn't it? Yeah.
I hate your new character. Your new character is an asshole.
Okay. I asked you what visitors to Stonehenge were given in the Victorian period to enhance their experience. What did you all put?
Victorian period? You didn't say that.
No, you didn't say that. You said, what do they give at Stonehenge?
And we said, audio guide. In the...
I said... Okay. So what I said was... What I said was in the 19th century.
Well, now I feel a dick. Audio guard. I know they weren't invented.
Because we put lube or audio guide.
Otherwise, you can't get the audio guide in.
Yes.
I think you're using those wrong.
We went for mushrooms, which was actually historically accurate for the last 5,000 years.
You know they have to put a fence around Stonehenge because people... obviously graffiti it, and they shit next to the stones. That's how we are great as a race. We take shits by Stonehenge.
Well, the answer is, in the Victorian period, visitors were given one of these. They were given a chisel and a hammer, and they were encouraged to just take a bit home with you, take a souvenir, have a little look, take a bit home.
Wow.
Chelsea, have you been to Stonehenge?
No.
You don't have to, just look at my teeth.
You're on your honeymoon. You should check it out. I can't believe you chose to come here on your honeymoon, but...
This seems weird that you didn't bring your husband, to be honest.
He's under the desk.
Yeah, he's pleasuring me.
He's warning you?
Pleasuring.
Oh, yeah, okay,
good. Ever heard of it?
Okay, well, no points to anyone. Finally, I showed you a clip of an American preacher going mad about something. What had got him so upset? What have you got, Alan?
Prohibition.
Ramesh? Prohibition?
Yeah.
No. Eddie, what have you got?
That says prohibition. That's moonshine, because you said that, and that is his... he's pissed off with his lack of hair.
Dara, Chelsea?
It was the first AA meeting. He's not a good speaker.
Yeah.
We can all agree on that.
He worked out that it's a Southern Baptist thing, isn't it, from America? Isn't that Southern...
Yeah, I guess so.
You know that thing they do where they try and distract from the fact that they're talking absolute bullshit?
But, no, I get it. Like, your leaders always tell the truth, so...
They don't. They don't move much. No.
He was angry about the end of Prohibition. Points all round.
All right.
Yay!
Yeah. Yeah. That was vague what you came up with.
So at the end of the first round, the scores are everyone's got two. Join us after the break for more of this show. What else did you expect? See you in a bit. To the Big Fat Quiz of everything. The next round is all about science. It's worth remembering scientific experiments can sometimes go disastrously wrong. Just look at Noel.
Oh, my God, I wasn't even listening, and I got absolutely dissed. I could feel it.
Revolutionary Italian scientist Galileo built his own telescope, discovered Jupiter's moons, and spent the rest of his time doing the Fandango. Incredible, especially considering he was just a poor boy from a poor family. Galileo had his critics. The Catholic Church ordered him not to tell anyone the Earth went round the sun. Although, to be fair, it's not the worst thing the Catholic Church have hushed up.
You cut to me a picture of me like the... We better get a reaction from the paddy on this one. Kind of strong feelings. Maybe one tear will slowly run down his face. Oh, Father Flaherty, why? Why? I trusted you.
OK. Some science questions for you. Have a look at this puppet head.
Passport photo.
That is not my passport photo. That is a creepy-looking puppet. It's nothing like me. That puppet head played a starring role in the invention of something. What was it?
Jimmy's career.
Just heard you say Jimmy's career then.
Yeah.
Right?
Slash life.
Next question. Inventor Thomas Edison coined the greeting hello for when you answer the phone. He came up with hello. But the actual inventor of the telephone, Alexander Graham Bell, wanted people to say something else when they picked up a phone. What was it?
It does look like he's talking to a very small Loch Ness monster, doesn't it?
Next question. Take a look at this picture from 1977. It's known as the Wow signal. After a very excited scientist wrote wow in the margin, but why did he write it?
Was he pretending to be dead or some bullshit?
No, Romesh, he was not. And I don't appreciate your tone.
Am I dragging him down because I'm like the bad boy of the group?
I didn't want to have to say it, Alan, but that is the case, yeah. You two shouldn't be allowed to sit together.
The twins can never be separated, fuck you.
And finally, over to Made in Chelsea shagger in residence, Jamie Lang.
Hello, Jimmy. Now, according to the world's best-selling medical textbook, which I have obviously read from cover to cover, what can be described as the slider, the staccato, or drumbeat type, and the bark?
OK, so according to the Merck manual, the official medical textbook, what could be described as a slider, staccato, a drumbeat, or a bark? It's all to do with the human body.
According to the what manual?
Yeah.
It's the Merck manual, the official medical textbook.
Medical textbook. Sounds like a guide of how to beat the shit out of people. Do you know what I mean? You're going to get murked, bruv.
OK, have you all got something?
Yes, Jimmy.
So I showed you a picture of a rather beautiful puppet head, which was instrumental in the invention of something. What was it?
Your career. Gets the same laugh
same
every
laugh.
Time.
Same laugh.
We all wrote Jimmy's dad. We all just went straight
did you put Jimmy's dad?
Yeah.
I thought it was that doll. You know at A&E, that doll you kiss to show how you like...
But its mouth isn't open.
Huh? Yeah, you have to get it open. It's the first one, mate. That was a design flaw.
It was actually John Logie Baird's puppet, and it was the first thing ever seen on television.
All right.
Oh. So some things don't change. I'm still here. Take a look at the footage. It could not be creepier.
The first ever
television image. It gets creepier. Oh.
First episode of Big Fat Quiz.
OK, next question. I asked you what word Alexander Graham Bell suggested we should say when answering the telephone. What did you think? OK, who's it? Alan?
Do you have PPI?
Chelsea.
You do it. You're the local.
You slag! There we go. Boom!
No, Eddie.
The person would answer it and just go, fuck off.
You got the wrong number. Oh, it could just be heavy breathing. You wanted people to just go.
Well, actually, Alexander Graham Bell suggested we all answer the phone by saying ahoy.
Ahoy?
Ahoy.
Yeah. Ahoy, you slag!
I showed you this picture. A very excited scientist has scribbled wow in the margin. Why had he written wow?
Oh, yeah, because he thought it was an alien, or was it evidence of aliens?
Okay, well, let's just find out. Dara, you're sort of a science expert.
Yep, it's actually very well known. It was discovered, the moon was discovered in 1967, and that was the first proof of the moon. And it's remarkable, because only 2 years later they travelled there.
1977.
You said 67.
77.
Oh. I retract our answer.
Okay, Noel, Eddie?
What? He's circling numbers, so I thought he was playing bingo. And he got a 7, and he went, wow. I never usually get a 7.
Well, Alan and Romesh have it exactly right. He thought it was aliens.
Yeah.
It was the scientist was, I'm sure, Romesh and Alan would tell us, was part of SETI, the search for extraterrestrial life, and he thought he'd discovered extraterrestrials, so he wrote, wow.
But would aliens send that message? We will send them. 6, EQ, U, J and 5.
Why do aliens never, ever go, like, to, like, New York or LA? Yeah. They always go, like, I saw an alien horseshit. None of those kind of people, don't they?
It's always Croydon, every single time.
Finally, Jamie Lang asked you what could be described as a slider, staccato, a drum beat, or a bark in a medical dictionary. What did you go for there, Alan,
like,
Romesh?
Different kinds of joints, like you've got slider joint and then a
staccato. Staccato joint will get you messed up, man. Yeah. No, we thought they're types of joint, yeah.
What did you get, Noel?
Someone who swallowed a drum machine. Because then they'll get slider and backbeat and all that stuff coming out of their body.
Dara, Chelsea, what did you...?
We thought it was types of taint.
You are so close.
Correct.
See, I don't think people here know what taint is.
Yeah. Do we all know what a taint is?
I didn't know what taint was.
Taint.
My God.
Taint is a magical area. It's between the hump and the hay.
I believe it's the perineum is the proper medical term.
Wow, so that's not an... You guys don't say taint.
We say gooch.
Why are you saying that so threatening?
I'm just saying... I'm just saying, if you want to be in this country, say gooch. All right.
These are, in fact, from the Merck Manual's essay on flatulence. They're all descriptions of farts.
That's not a part of the body.
Yeah, thank you, yes. Another bullshit answer from your question.
Yeah.
Where's your fart? Show me your fart now, Jimmy.
Show your fart.
Show us your fart. He's misleading us in the questions, and they're not...
Questions!
You did it right.
So no points for anyone there. OK, let's have a look and see what that's done to the scores. Dara and Chelsea, Noel and Eddie are on 2. Alan and Romesh are in the lead with an incredible 3.
Yeah!
Quite low scoring. See you after the break when one of our lucky studio audience members will win the chance to go to the toilet. See you in a bit. Back to the Big Fat Quiz of Everything. Our next round is all about film and TV. Mary Poppins famously sang, "A spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down," which is brilliant advice, unless you're taking medicine for your diabetes. The longest-running TV show is BBC's current affairs flagship, Panorama. It's 63 years old and on the BBC, so it's only a matter of time before it's arrested for interfering with one of the younger programmes. Right, ready for some Big Fat Questions? First up, take a look at this classic scene from Thunderball starring best-ever Bond, Sean Connery. What I want to know is, what killer line does Bond say next?
This is a Geiger counter. You press this lever. If it starts clicking, it means the bombs are aboard.
What do I do then?
Go straight up on deck. As a Disco Volante is being watched, you'll be spotted.
Varga's behind you.
Really?
Must have followed us.
Okay, what does he say next?
That is so bad. We can't put that.
How bad is it?
Shitney speared. That is crap. That is crap.
That's a round of applause.
I know.
Let's put it.
If I do that thing, Romesh, Alan, behave.
Sorry.
Is it as good as... Romesh, Alan, is it as good as Shitney Spears?
Oh, nothing could be as good as that.
Next question. The Hollywood sign in LA is one of the most iconic landmarks in the world, but originally it looked like this. What I want to know is, what was it originally for? What was the original purpose of the Hollywood sign?
Supposed to be temporary.
Chelsea, you live in Hollywood, right?
I can't tell anyone where I live. I try to hide it.
Are you on witness protection?
Yeah, but they let me do this. This was my one out.
Next question. In cult TV classic The Prisoner, what stops prisoner number 6 from escaping the village where he's being held? Chelsea, pretty easy one.
Bars.
It is not bars. For our last question, it's over to Kaiser Chief Ricky Wilson.
Hi, Jimmy. Now, as a child of the 80s, I grew up with some incredible films. One of my personal favourites was Gremlins. But, according to the movie, what 3 things should you never, ever do to a Mogwai?
Pretty straightforward. What should you never do to a Mogwai? There are 3 things.
If you can read any of our stuff, you win a prize.
We all got answers?
Yeah.
All right, first up, I showed you a clip of the magnificent Thunderball. What did James Bond say after harpooning that man? What did you put?
Dara, have you lost weight? It did look a bit like him.
Dara?
Well, Jasmine wanted to go very dry and classic.
Frontal, anal, hand...
No, oh. That's not... No, for this one. For this one.
Well, oh, what are you saying?
I jumped ahead to a different question.
What? What? Possibly? Where did you...
That's frontal, anal...
What?
That's...
What?
Forget we said frontal, anal, anything, right? That is for a later time. Wipe that from your mind, OK?
You'll get it later.
Later.
Thank
later.
You, yeah. Chelsea. Yeah. Okay, so what did you go for the James Bond question? What did James Bond say next?
We had a difference of opinion.
Okay. Yeah, we had a huge debate because we remembered it differently. I thought he was like, "Damn it, I forgot to put the safety on."
Which is quite James Bond. Whereas I thought it went, "Booyah!" right in the coconuts. Because it was a coconut trick.
Noel, Eddie, what did you put?
Well, he got the point.
Well, let's take a look at the ever suave James Bond delivering his killer line.
He must have followed us.
I think he got the point.
And he is off. Huge. Good knowledge.
In real life. Because when the things he says to women, if you said those things to women, you'd get arrested. Like, "Oh, Clitty, I'd like to rub you up the wrong way." And they're like, oh, they go, "Oh, James." And you'd be sharing a cell with Rolf Harris if you said it in real life.
So I asked you what the original Hollywoodland sign was put up for.
Testing out Google Maps, you know, when you... You know, when you look on the map and they've got it actually written on top of it, you know where you're going.
It's a fine answer. Dara, Chelsea?
We think it was a housing development at the time.
The absolute right answer, yeah. Well, no, Eddie, right. You get this?
Again, Eddie could have written anything nobody knows.
OK.
To sell real estate called Hollywood Land.
That's the right answer. Big tick.
All right.
So points to you, points to you. No points to you. OK, I asked you what prevented prisoner number 6 from escaping the village in The Prisoner. What did you all think?
He wrote this. I know you think I wrote it. He wrote it.
Romesh, will you phrase that in a slightly odd way?
It's a big balls, isn't it? Like, stop him, like, chasing him around and that.
What, Chelsea, do you get this?
I said bars are like a prison guard.
Have you really never seen this, Chelsea?
No, should I?
Oh.
At Stonehenge on a little portable player.
Yeah.
What? At least
while I'm shitting.
Quite an image.
But then we wrote down a giant bouncing ball.
No, Eddie?
Rover. It was Rover. A huge balloon.
Well, let's take a look. Chelsea, your first impressions of The Prisoner?
It feels like one of those videos playing in a museum that you just go, like, and then you walk past it. You know, like, media arts, yeah, or you're just like, cool.
Ricky Wilson asked you what were the rules regarding ownership of a Mogwai. What did you all get? I need three rules.
Well,
feeding after midnight, that's one.
Yeah.
Pouring water over them, and then we...
Something about bright lights.
Bright lights. Remember them? They don't like bright lights. Don't.
You are 3 for 3.
Really?
I promised myself I wouldn't cry. We are like twins.
Dara, Chelsea, did you get this?
Frontal, anal, handy.
See, but I misheard. I misheard. When she said frontal, I misheard and wrote down parental anal handy instead.
Oh, parental anal handy is the worst.
But we got wet and food after midnight, so...
That sounds sexy as well. I got this right by accident. I put water, bright light, and then I thought, oh, it'll be funny, put hummus. But that's sort of right, isn't it?
OK, points, no points, no points.
What about hummus?
OK, now time for a special bonus round. I'm going to show you some stills from 3 classic TV shows which have all been subtly improved. Can you tell me what the shows are? So you've just got to write down 3 TV shows. Here is the first one.
What is that
TV show? OK, that second show? Oh, yeah. We're just... What you can't see is we're just at Stonehenge taking a shit there. And the third classic TV show?
Oh, OK.
did you find so perfect a photograph of me that I was actually at the exact right angle in fear?
They might have turned it.
Oh, OK. Yeah.
That makes more sense, yeah, that makes more sense. All right, let's have your answers on this. The first one, it was, of course, Baywatch. I think you all got that. OK, the second one, that's me and Chelsea doing our best Mulder and Scully. X-Files. And the last one, have you ever seen this, Chelsea? I don't know if we can explain this to you.
Is that from Annie? That's Miss Hannigan and...
Yep, three times.
Some orphans.
Some orphans.
You all got this. Last of the summer line. Let's take a look and see what that's done to the scores. OK, so in last place, Dara and Chelsea with 7. Joint leaders, Alan and Romesh, Noel and Eddie, have 8. Join us after the break when we'll be finding out which one of our panellists is the real father. See you in a bit. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of Everything. This round is all about music. Music lovers are spoiled for choice. There's pop, rock, country, classical, punk, hip-hop, rap, reggae and dance. And for people who don't like music, there's jazz. OK, questions, everyone. Take a look at this clip of young Harry Styles wannabe, Bob Dylan, performing in 1965. All I want to know is, why is Bob Dylan being booed?
Is it anything to do with hummus?
Yeah. Next up, obviously Japan's greatest gift to the world is karaoke. All I want to know is, what does karaoke actually mean?
Oh, shit. Ooh. Hummus?
For our next question, it's over to the Channel 4 newsroom where legendary journalist Jon Snow is reporting on a classic song. Over to you, Jon.
Scientists in America are calling for volunteers to participate in a study investigating the controversial theory that men who are attracted to large posteriors are unable to tell lies. Researchers became aware of the unique condition after a girl walked in with an itty-bitty waist and a round thing in their face. According to a press release, scientists are looking for volunteers with a specific body type. And those who have not got buns are discouraged from participating on the basis that the research team don't want none. Applicants must also be sweat wet and have it going like a turbo vet. When asked to comment, one researcher who gave her name only as Becky said, "Oh my God, look at her butt." Back to you, Jimmy.
Thank you, John. John Snow there. Chelsea, have you got something down?
Correct. Yes, we do. Thank you.
You're very kind. Check it
out. OK, I've got some lady speed sticks. These are American deodorants, and they inspired a very famous song. What was that song? No, that's obviously, we've taken the name off the deodorant. OK, here we go. There you go. So these deodorants inspired a famous song. What song was that?
This inspired a song.
This inspired a song. You'll all know the song.
I'm calling you. Can you pick up?
What is it, Noel? Oh, sorry. Ahoy. Are you putting this on?
I've put it on already. It's nice. It is.
It smells like a yogurt.
Oh my God, I actually had to lift it up to put underneath my tip.
Right, has everyone got an answer? So I showed you a clip of young Harry Styles wannabe Bob Dylan performing in 1965. Why was he booed off stage?
You see, that gig where he changed to an electric guitar.
That is exactly the right answer.
Thank you.
What have you got, Noel, Eddie?
We've got whatever Eddie wrote.
First two with electric guitars.
I wrote electric hummus because I was still angry about the hummus. But I think you get it from my answer.
Chelsea, you've now got a catchphrase, but I'm afraid to say your catchphrase is...
Parental anal handy. Also known as electric guitar, because we don't lose the point. We like the joke, but we don't lose the points.
Points, points, points.
Thank you.
Great, thank you.
Excellent, okay.
And next up, I asked you what karaoke translates as in English. What did you get?
Is it Lucky Voice?
Lucky Voice is the name of a karaoke bar in London.
Yeah, that's isn't that what the question was? That
yeah, that was it. Name a karaoke bar in London.
Yeah, that's what I said. Yeah, sure, sure.
That's what I heard.
That's what we think you said, Jimmy. Yeah. So will you give us a fucking point?
Yeah.
Because your head's got the wobble on.
You do that back to me, mate. That's racist.
Eddie, Noel, did you get this?
Eddie wrote Song Murder, which I think is perfect.
Dara, Chelsea?
It's empty Oki, but we think Oki's voice. Empty voice.
Oh, so close.
Empty soul.
Empty social calendar, that's why you're doing karaoke?
Yeah.
It's empty orchestra. Next, you saw Jon Snow putting on a classic song. What was that song?
Baby Got Back, so mix a lot.
It's absolutely correct.
We put the Right Honourable Sir Mix-a-Lot.
Well, Sir Mix-a-Lot is correct.
The song is popularly known as I Like Big Butts. But it's definitely by the Right Honourable Sir
Mix-a-Lot. I think I would probably give you that.
Are you shitting me?
Are you genuinely shitting on my face?
They got the title.
It's not name a random lyric from the bloody song. Look, we've given you the fucking title here, mate. And they just come up with any old
shit. I'm just glad you're not taking this too seriously,
Don't mess with him, Jimmy. Don't mess with him.
We think it's Lord Mixer sometimes. We still give us a point.
Oh, Romesh, I love it when you're angry. Which is lucky, because it's all the fucking time. Noel, Eddie, what have you got?
We didn't get this right, Jimmy.
Have you written Beyoncé songs about bums?
I wrote Beyoncé's.
I put song about bums.
I mean, it is a song about bums. There's no getting away from it.
Just give him the point, mate.
It's pretty close.
Yeah. I tell you you do not cross the twins, mate, and live to talk about it. That's all I'm saying.
Could one of the twins do up one of your shirt buttons?
We are turning into bloody twins.
Let's go back to Jon Snow and find out.
I like big butts and I cannot lie. Once in a while, thing in your face, you get sprung. Wanna go out to me, but you notice that butt was stuck. Even the jeans she's wearing, I'm hooked and I can't stop staring. Oh, baby, I wanna get better.
Okay, for our final question, I showed you the American deodorant Lady Speedstick. What famous song did it inspire? Romesh.
Links Africa.
You think it's the song Links Africa. Africa?
Yeah, that top.
You know
top
that song it goes, I wore deodorants called Links Africa. Yeah. My taint is smelly, I use Links Africa. My gooch is tangy, Links Africa.
Chelsea, what did you get from that fine aroma?
Smells like teen spirit.
Noel, Eddie?
Smells like teen spirit, Jimmy. I can't believe you put this on, it's Prittstick.
No, it's not.
You were right, it was Smells Like Teen Spirit. There it is, there's the actual deodorant.
I was right.
That was a joke. We wrote that down as a joke. Was it the voice, right?
That's the right answer. It smells like Teen Spirit. It is a ladies' deodorant. So someone wrote on Kurt Cobain's wall, Kurt Cobain smells like Teen Spirit, and he thought it sounded cool, but someone wrote it to kind of say you smell like a girl. OK, time now for a special bonus round. You've each got a famous style of facial hair under your desk. Grab them and put them on. I simply want to know what each one is called.
Wait,
Alan, that's upside down. Dara. Dara, they go there.
Oh.
Oh.
Does mine too?
No, yours goes. No, no, you had yours right. Yours was right. Now you look ridiculous, Chelsea. Put it on the right way.
Oh, fine. Ow!
Chelsea, if you could grow that, would you?
Yes, of course.
Stop tonguing your own bush.
Oh, Dara.
You look like you're in Downton Abbey. It's amazing.
I look like a folk singer.
You guys look like an amazing double act now. I would buy that record if that was the cover. Okay, have you all got them down? You went with, for the first one, Alan's?
We went with goatee.
Goatee.
Yeah, that is the goatee.
Oh, okay, God, I didn't think you could look any more sinister, but I was wrong.
Yeah. Good luck. Okay, so that was the goatee. I think you all got that, yeah?
Yeah,
you've all got goatee. Yeah. Okay, so this one, wow. What did you all get?
Handlebar.
Handlebar.
Handlebar. Oh, yeah. Handlebar must have. There you go, it's going to be easier. Dara, you were sporting the. I mean, you're not wearing those in the traditional manner.
We thought they were called buggery grips.
I think bugger grips. I think that's maybe an acceptable answer. That, I mean, what did you get, Dara, Chelsea?
We just put sideburns down. I know there's a
mutton chops.
Mutton chops is the correct. Noel and Eddie get it. Mutton chops. What was the next one? So this is Chelsea's. What do you think?
We put Yosemite Sam down for that.
What did you think, Eddie?
Oh, walrus.
Okay. Walrus. Yeah, it's the walrus from Sash. Noel, you look amazing. Look at that. Okay, so that was the horseshoe.
Can we get a point for... We put goalposts. Like, it looks like a goal.
It does look like a goalpost.
We put droopy
on. So no-one got that one. And then, yeah. I want one of these.
That's pencil. Pencil.
Pencil.
Pencil. Yeah,
we
pencil.
We put caterpillar.
Spin. So at the end of that, Alan and Romesh have 12, Dara and Chelsea have 13, and Noel and Eddie have 15. Suddenly in the lead. Join us after the break. We'll more be finding out if our celebrities know anything about the natural world. Spoiler alert, they definitely don't. See you in a bit. To the big fat quiz of everything. The next round is all about the natural world. In North America, a tornado is defined as a narrow, violently rotating column of air that extends from the base of a thundercloud to the ground. Whilst in Britain, a tornado is defined as any wind strong enough to blow over a wheelie bin. Insects have an array of predators that regularly try to eat them. There's birds, reptiles, and Z-list celebrities on ITV. Right, let's have some questions. First up, have a listen to this sound. All I want to know is what was that? If I'm not mistaken, Romesh is deciding whether or not to write down Dara's mum. Don't write. I could see the thought bubble.
No, I wasn't going to write that. She just doesn't sound anything like that.
For our next question, it's over to survival expert Ray Mears.
Hi, Jimmy. I've survived the Amazon jungle, but I was lucky enough not to come across the Brazilian wandering spider, one of the world's most venomous creatures. Its bite can be deadly, but it also has an unusual side effect. What is it?
So Ray wants to know what unusual side effect the Brazilian wandering spider's bite has. Romesh, Alan, something funny? Would you care to share the joke with the class?
You'll see the magic when you see the screen.
Such a professional. OK, there's the Brazilian wandering spider. Adorable. I can give you a clue on this, because it's quite difficult. The side effect is it only really affects men.
Ah, yeah.
It makes your balls disappear.
Here's a clip of David Attenborough doing what he does best, whispering in the jungle.
What bird has the most elaborate, the most complex, the most beautiful song in the world? Well, I guess there are lots of contenders, but this bird must be one of them. The superb lyrebird of South Australia.
So, what's special about the lyrebird? Noel, what are you eating?
Salad.
There's a whole salad bar under here.
It's got hummus in it.
OK, time for a say what you see. Take a look at these pictures. They spell out a famous natural wonder. What is it?
What was this? We're looking at what?
So you're looking at the pictures and they spell out a famous natural wonder.
Oh, shit.
Or a lie.
Does this say what you see?
Yes.
Puppet.
No, on the screen. Yeah. OK, yes. Everyone's got something? Here we go.
How's that salad?
Well, that's what it would look like if salad was illegal. OK, some answers. I asked you what this noise was.
Is it a donkey in the distance?
OK. Dara, Chelsea. Oh, Chelsea, yes, what did you go with?
It was like...
We're at stop clock. We're going to be right one of these days. This is going to be the correct answer eventually.
We went with our signature answer, Jimmy.
OK.
Parental, anal, handy. I forgot the end.
What did you go for? Noel? I mean...
How big is that bloody salad? How big is that salad?
He's doing the washing up.
It's
right?
Tiny.
It does. That's exactly what he looks like.
Can I just hear that? Can I hear the noise again? Just
one, yeah, one. Sure.
Okay. And I said that was a baby being inflated.
It's a very good answer. I mean, it's not in any way right, but it sounds very...
It's pretty close. And if you actually do record a baby being inflated and play that noise next to this noise... What... You will find they are so similar that even experts will say, I think it's a baby being inflated.
I'm sorry, Jimmy, you hand inflate your babies?
Old school.
How do you do yours?
Oh, I have a motorised pump. I just put my foot down and then...
Alan and Romesh, you went with...
He said you believe he was straight as soon as he heard it.
Yeah,
he went,
that sounds like a tortoise shagging.
Well, let's take a look.
Oh, my God, you were right.
You knew that? Have you seen that piece before?
No, I just know that's what a tortoise sounds like when he's getting out.
How could you... How...
You got a tortoise?
How did you know?
Yeah.
Just get easy. You look at it, you go, I reckon when he's going at it, that's what he sounds like. I could just... You could just I just... It's like a talent I've got.
Are you able to guess that with people as well?
Only one.
Oh, so you got a point there for tortoise shagging. Well, I'm slightly suspicious that it's going to turn out Romesh has done something terrible to a tortoise at some stage.
And it hasn't come out yet because it's taken the tortoise ages to go to the press. Yeah. It's the fourth proper joke I've ever done. I'm going to leave on that.
Ray Mears asked you what unusual effect the Brazilian wandering spider bite has. What did you put? Alan, Romesh?
Your taint tingles.
The bit in between tingles.
Your gooch.
Chelsea?
Well, I wouldn't phrase it this way because I'm American, but we said a big old stander.
How would you phrase it?
A boner?
Did you get this?
We went with impotent, the opposite. Yeah. We thought it maybe means... I'm not sure why if you got bitten by a spider you'd try and have sex, but...
Big old stander is the right answer, yeah. The bite gives men a painful four-hour erection.
Let me get a hold of that spider, Irene.
If I have an erection, erection that long, I'd look like that bloody tortoise shagging.
So, points for Dara and Chelsea on that one. OK, I showed you a clip of David Attenborough whispering in the jungle about the lyrebird. What was so special about the lyrebird?
It tells the truth.
If it bites you, you get a semi.
Chelsea Peretti, what did you write?
It shat in his hat.
You're rolling on the bit where Attenborough goes, it shat me fucking hat!
That was a great impression.
It's a very good You stag! I'm David Attenborough, mate! I'm David Attenborough! I will ruin you! You will be a trophy! A fucking trophy!
Ladies and gentlemen, the worst ever impression of David Attenborough! Sorry, what did you put, Alan? Romesh?
We put, you cannot see David Attenborough, because... He was so bloody close to that thing, and it didn't notice him at all.
So you think the special thing about the lyrebird is it can't see David Attenborough?
Dude, he's practically bloody in its face, man, and he can't see it.
Say you're David Attenborough, I'm that bird, look.
And the incredible thing about him...
I said, you know what? You know what I'm going to say? That drama degree finally paying off. Let's take a look at the lyrebird in action.
He also, in his attempt to outsing his rivals, incorporates other sounds that he hears in the forest. That was a camera shutter. And now a camera with a motor drive. And that's a car alarm. And now, the sounds of foresters and their chainsaws working nearby.
This is fake!
That's fake. This is that's fake. Not real.
That's no
that's
way!
That is 100%
no,
real.
That's the guy from Police Academy!
When's a lyrebird had a car alarm? When's it been wandering around town going, boo, boo, boo,
boo? Your camera pulls out and there's a bloke with two coconut shells going, and now a horse.
So it's the lyrebird can mimic any noise it hears. No one gets a point. Finally, I showed you a say what you see of a famous natural phenomenon. What did you think it was? Chelsea, did you get this?
Yes.
OK, yeah. Tell us.
Row, roar, Pharaoh, Piggy, Alice. Was our first guess.
OK. And what's your second
guess? We're still working on it.
Yeah.
Romesh.
We put...
Aurora. Aurora.
Aurora Borealis.
No, Eddie.
Aurora Borealis. Aurora Borealis.
It was, of course, Aurora Borealis. The Aurora Borealis. OK, points, points, no points. I've got a very special treat for you now. Here to help me ask the next question are two very special guests. They don't like loud noise, so please very quietly welcome Talita and Tiago.
Oh, they're sloths.
That is literally the cutest thing I've ever seen. I mean, you can come and say hello if you want. Come and have a look. They're impossibly cute. Oh. OK, so obviously we had to bring on two sloths to ask the question, so I'll get the sloth to... There you go. You read the question.
Oh, my God, they're so cute.
Well, don't, yeah, they can read. Well, don't be... Why are you being a dick? Honestly, I'm over here. If you could just read the... Oh, no, I can see sloth junk. Pretty impressive.
Good name for a band.
Sloth junk. Well, look, I'll read the question. So, sloth is one of the seven deadly sins. What you've got to do is name the other six deadly sins. So sit back down, write down the answer. The other six deadly sins. No, you can't ask the animal handlers.
They don't know, so it's useless.
The nails are just adorable. You all got something down?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Even the sloths are going, hurry up, mate.
OK, let's have a look and see what you've all got.
Envy, greed, lust, vanity, gluttony.
Dara, Chelsea, what do you get?
We have lust, gluttony, pride, greed, wrath, and envy.
Noel, Eddie, how did you do?
Envy, gluttony, wrath, pride, avarice, and whimsy for because I forgot lust.
So the definitive answer, lust or lechery, pride or vanity, envy, wrath or anger, gluttony, greed or avarice.
Or whimsy.
OK, so, Noel, Eddie, you got five of the remaining deadly sins, and Dara, Chelsea, Alan, Romesh, you got full houses. So, well, it's neck and neck. Alan and Romesh have 20, Dara and Chelsea have 20, Noel and Eddie just in the lead with 21. Join us after the break, but for now, ladies and gentlemen, Talita and Tiago, the Sloths. See you in a bit. Part of the Big Fat Quiz of Everything. Our next round is all about culture and fashion. Charles Dickens' Oliver Twist tells the story of an orphan who famously asked for more. It's a wonderful book and it taught me a valuable lesson. Orphans are greedy little fucks. The Sydney Opera House was completed in 1973 and is Australia's most famous building. The question remains, though, why build an opera house in Australia? It's like buying Ed Sheeran a sunbed. OK, time for some questions. The Mona Lisa is arguably the most famous painting in the world. It's been described as the embodiment of the ideal woman. Beautiful, enigmatic, receptive, and still just out of reach. What is she physically missing?
Well, that is that sensible, that's what it is.
Final round. It's very exciting. It's all to play for.
So tight, Jimmy!
Next question. Take a look at this picture of a photographer taking a photo. What is he taking a photo of? He's taking a very, very famous photo right there. Alan, Romesh, you got something?
No.
So he's taking a photo there.
Yeah, I know, love. I can see. I don't wear these for love.
Next up, I've got a special treat for you. Joey Essex has made a remarkable documentary about a cultural icon. Who on earth is he talking about?
My name's Joey Essex, and today I want to talk to you about a top geese who played a big part in British culture. This guy had a bit of swagger. He was posh. He reminded me of that guy, you know, the one out of James Bond, Oddjob, with that silly hat, who he sometimes threw at people to chop their necks off and things like that. He constantly drank champagne and he used whiskey as mouthwash. He smoked a ridiculous amount of cigars. He lived the party lifestyle of an absolute G. And Richard went up to him once and said to him, "You're always pissed." Well, he went, "Well, you're always butters." And in the morning when he woke up, he said, "I'll be pissed, but you'll always be butters." He was proper motivational. He always talked about having fights on beaches and having beef in the middle of fields. I'm not talking about cows. I'm talking about actual tear-ups in the middle of the streets. But then after, he would say, "I'm never going to surrender." So there you have it. He was a bulldog, but he was human. He was always steaming. He was a sick speaker, and he was a proper boat.
Chelsea, did you understand anything he was saying there?
The exact words, and I don't want to misquote your words, who was that man? fuck me if I can explain.
Next question. Take a look at this clip from the 1960s. What are these people talking about?
I don't think it's... Yeah, you know, they all be locked up, people wearing stuff like that. Well, I think it's a fine idea myself. I think it is healthy, for one thing.
Would you, then?
No. I like to leave a little to the imagination.
The wife had one, well, I don't know. I think we should be chasing around the garden after one another, I think.
Well, I think it is very distracting to the men. And I like it on the young lady, but I wouldn't fancy myself in it.
Why not?
Well, I look a proper Charlie, wouldn't I?
OK, so what we want to know is, what is Alan's mum talking about?
Romesh and Spirit, they're twins. Look at them.
Oh, sorry, Romesh. Is your mum out of bounds, is it?
Are you ready for some answers?
So ready, Jimmy.
Okay,
so
right.
ready.
Here we go. Okay, I asked you what the Mona Lisa was missing. Romesh. Let's just take a look at the full Mona Lisa. I mean,
yeah, is that not right? Where's the bottom half? You can't see it.
We're at the bottom half. Noel, Eddie, what did you have?
We put diving watch at first.
Yeah, it's a good point. She doesn't have a diving watch on.
Eddie put smile and I put question mark. Then we put arm. I think it's arm, isn't it?
How can it be arm?
OK, Dara, Chelsea?
Eyebrows.
So, you've got eyebrows.
Over eyebrows.
Let's take a look. She's got no eyebrows.
Or bottom half.
Or diving watch. Yeah. Watch. That is factually correct. She hasn't got a wolf called Susan, a colouring book, or a mango, or any hummus. Fuck you, Jimmy.
He did do eyebrows at the beginning, of course.
Well, do you know what? One theory is he did eyebrows, and then they tried to clean the painting, and they went. It was some restoration work that they...
So there were eyebrows in the painting at one point, whereas there was never a bottom half.
OK, points to Dara and Chelsea. I showed you a picture of a photographer taking a very famous photo. Chelsea, did you get it?
Dudes lunching on a steel bar.
Oh,
sure.
They were dudes.
Famously lunching.
Yeah. Well, let's take a look. Those are some dudes famously
in your
lunching.
Face. Boom.
OK, Noel, Eddie, did you get this?
Yeah, the construction workers sitting on a skyscraper.
That's exactly the right answer.
All right, well, that exactly takes some of the glory out of my...
Alan, Romesh?
Well, we couldn't think. We just thought, like, Statue of Liberty or something.
OK, so zero.
I mean,
yeah,
to be fair...
That. Yeah, zero, yeah.
To be fair, that would be a better photo than a bunch of pricks having lunch. Like, that's a good photo.
On a girder, who gives a shit?
Yeah.
You get a point. And you get a point. No points for you. You saw Joey Essex talking about a cultural icon. Who was it?
Couldn't give a shit, mate, at this point.
Let's have a look. What did you get?
Winston Churchill. Can accept that, or shall I put Churchill the fucking dog?
I will accept Winston Churchill, yeah. Dara, Chelsea?
Yes, same.
Noel, Eddie?
Winston Churchill.
OK, points all round on that. Well done, Joey Essex. I showed you a clip of people being interviewed about something in the swinging 60s. What did you think?
Miniskirts.
Points all round. Miniskirts. Oh, yeah. OK, for our final question, as a special treat, we've enlisted some help. Will you please welcome Javier from Melbourne, Matt from Weston-super-Mare and Gary from Uxbridge. OK, lads, strike a pose.
No one's expecting that.
These gentlemen are all from my chess club and they're each mimicking a famous statue. All you have to do is name that statue.
Can we get one of those spiders? Is that his natural bush there? Because he looks like...
Is that his... What, where?
He looks like he's run his cock through a Muppet.
If you could not say anything funny, because if you say something funny, his junk kind of wobbles up and down. It's like super distracting. It's like, I'm just getting... Because he's... Yeah, if you could not giggle... Can you not giggle? Because your balls go weird when you giggle and you know...
Can I get Discus Guy to stop staring me? That is all he's doing.
His dick's like the Mona Lisa. It follows me around the room.
OK, let's get some answers.
Sweeping, it's the thinker, David and Apollo.
Dara, Chelsea?
Oh, we've gone for Rodin's the thinker, Michelangelo, David and the discus guy.
OK, Noel, Eddie?
The thinker, David and the Olympian.
Well, I can tell you that Dara and Chelsea, you got all three. It's the thinker, David, and the discus thrower.
Oh, hang on a second. Wait. Hang on. Controversially, the discus thrower or the discus Olympian is actually right. The Olympian is also the right answer.
Yes!
Wait, so we got it right and they got it half right.
No. The Olympian is no more right than the discus guy, but it's as right.
But just hearing it now, the judges have said everybody's correct except for Alan and Romesh. That's the way. That's the way. Just having that clear.
Well, thank you to our statues. Addies. Just.
Yeah!
Our statues, everyone. Our statues. Well, that is your lot. Time to trot up your scores at home. There are a possible 42 points to be earned this evening. Here's how our teams did. Alan and Romesh, 24 points. Not enough. Dara, Chelsea, you got 27 points. But Noel and Eddie, with 27 points, you are the same as Dara and Chelsea. We have joint winners, Dara and Chelsea, Noel and Eddie. You will have to share your trophy. A big thank you to our amazing panel and a special thanks to all our guests. Thank you for watching. I'm Jimmy Carr. This has been the Big Fat Quiz of Everything. Good night.
A very specific quest for a straight Paul O'Grady. See if he's out there in First Dates tomorrow at 9. And talking of dates, the new series Celebs Go Dating starts tomorrow at 10 over on E4. Next here tonight, who would have thought four men looking for a killer would find themselves defending the Earth from an alien invasion? Sci-fi comedy, The Watch.